In today's Eye on Health, a perfect topic for World Kindness Day totally fits with the philosophy of Mr. Rogers of helping others. It's about a place where people can go to get help dealing with grief, and the help there is offered at no charge. It is called, appropriately enough, the Caring Place, and Therese Vorshak is the director there. She is here with Kimberly and Brennan Fitzpatrick, who came to the Caring Place after the loss of Kimberly's mother and Brennan's grandmother. Thank you all for being here to talk about this, because I think it's such an important topic. Kimberly and Brennan, tell us what brought you to the Caring Place. Tell us your story.
Well, what brought me to the Caring Place is I lost my mother, mm-hmm. and it was all of a sudden, it was not expected, and I was having a hard time. I didn't even want to deal with it. And people at my church and had went through the program, had lost my close to them, had went through the program.
Okay, and in fact, Brennan's mic is working, yours we're having a little bit of an issue with, so maybe we could have Brennan pick up the story. You had heard about the program, and then what was it able to do for you? Was it really able to help you process and deal with this?
The Caring Place for me, Caring Place for me, it was, I don't know, like, at first, I was like, I don't need this, like, I don't need grief counseling. And then a friend of mine from the church we go to was like, no, it's a good thing for you, you'll love it. And
it has helped you too, right?
It helps
me
a lot.
Difference. Yeah. Kimberly, now that we have your mic fixed up, so I'm sorry to interrupt you, but pick up the story. So you went there because you realized there are services there that might be able to help.
Right? Yes, and I was told about these services, and I was told other people went through other programs, and they but this was a really good program, and other people really liked it. So I looked up the program, and I went there, and I registered to go.
How did it make a difference for you, and how did it make a difference for Brennan?
One, it helped, because we went together, it helped me be able to deal with my grief and not have to worry about, because my whole thing is I have to be strong for everybody else and try to understand what Brennan and how to deal with his grief and mine at the same time, which we both went and we both got support together.
Right.
How it helped me is just learn that grief is a journey. Like the tremendous kindness that's there, the non-judgment, and everybody there is going through the same thing. And they really, like, they think of everything.
Yeah.
And it really just helped me learn that grief is a journey and it's okay.
And I know losing a parent is something that it takes a long time to work through. You continue to work through it. Therese, talk to us about just the services that are provided there. What a great place. What a great resource in Pittsburgh.
Thank you so much. We're so proud to be in Pittsburgh. We've been here over 22 years now and have three other facilities in Pennsylvania. And we provide peer support for families like Brennan and Kimberly. When somebody in our family dies, a parent, a sibling, a grandparent, whether it's unexpected or, you know, after a lengthy illness, it turns our life upside down. Mm-hmm. And kids especially, but adults, as Kimberly has been talking about, you know, need that extra support to help you get that through that really rough time.
And there's actually a day that's coming up that you want to tell people about because you have some special things planned for that day. But sort of just to point out the importance of dealing with all this, tell us about that.
Sure. So a lot of people don't really understand that kids do grieve. Mm-hmm. You know, that we see kids as very resilient and they, you know, we think they bounce back from the tragedies in life very quickly. And actually that's not quite true. When a child has somebody die, they deal with it for the rest of their life. And so about 11 years ago, we created Children's Grief Awareness Day, and it's the third Thursday of every November. And it's coming up this Thursday or next Thursday, November 21st. And it's a day specifically to raise awareness about the impact of death on kids like Brennan and their need for support. And so throughout Pittsburgh and throughout the state, and actually it's become a national and international day of observance. So there's activities going across the nation. But here in Pittsburgh, we'll have at our facilities, we have open houses for the families that have come through our program. But we also have, we have an art installation that we do every year. It's called Illuminating Hope. And it's an art installation created by thousands of butterflies that we've collected throughout the city. that people have written the name of the person who have died, who has died, or a message of hope to grieving children. And we've taken, we have over 6,000 butterflies on this installation, and it lights up, and it's traveled throughout the city. And right now it's at the lobby at AGH, and next week it will be in Penn Avenue Place for the entire week if anybody wants
so
to
people
see
can
it.
See it there. And I bet it's very powerful to
it's
see
very,
all
It's very, very powerful. Yeah. Yes, illuminating hope is what we call it.
Thank you so much for sharing your stories, and I think it will help other people as well. And so we appreciate you
definitely
being here today.
Us.
Good, good. All right, well, look for more help on the services offered, again, at no charge at the Caring Place, as well as volunteer opportunities online. You will find the link at PittsburghTodayLive.com. And keep watching for our Eye on Health series here on PTL. Happens on Wednesdays, brought to you by Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield, together with Allegheny Health Network for your health.